Okay, you ready for your headliner? Yeah. No, you gotta do better than that. Yeah. You ready? Yeah, come on, you ready? Okay, a very funny man coming to the stage right now. You've seen him on The Tonight Show, The David Letterman Show, and HBO. Ladies and gentlemen, Ritch Shydner.
Great. I like coming down to San Diego. Don't like to drive down from Los Angeles because I always drive down. Like I had to go back today and I drove back, you know, during that rush hour drive. I hate that, man. You know, I hate that phenomenon, you know, where all the traffic stops for about an hour. Then you get up to 60 miles an hour for 30 feet. You stop for another hour and a half. Then you get up to 40 miles an hour for 10 feet, you know. It's like in the middle of a big slinky moving down the freeway, you know. And I always keep expecting to see some sort of reason for all this stopping and start. Maybe there's a gas truck explosion or a trash truck overturned or some reason, you know. But there's none. I just imagine one guy way up front going, ha, 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 ha. Oh, here we go, no or not, no or not. We'll go for third gear, no or not. And got caught behind a highway officer, patrol car, you know, which I always love that because you'll see a patrol car doing 55 and then a whole pack of cars riding right behind it, you know. Everyone's waiting for the officer to get off the freeway so they can get back up to 60, 70 miles an hour again, right? But finally, you know, the officer stayed on too long and then one guy will just lose patience, just peel away from the pack, you know? You'll see him make the move and everyone else is going, go, man, go! And you know there's a lot of stress in that car. Here we go, baby, don't look at him now, here we go. All right, we're easing by him now, 56, he wouldn't dare pull us over at 56, here we go now. All right, we're by him now, we're going to go for 58, no, no! Speeding tickets are the worst because you know there's always somebody when you get pulled over for a speeding ticket that's going to drive by about 100 miles an hour faster than you were going, you know. But you get pulled over for a speeding ticket. I got pulled over for a speeding ticket and it was in Ohio not too long ago. And you know, it's like I have 4 valid driver's licenses. If you ever move from one state to another, try to keep your old driver's license. That way if you get pulled over for something like speeding, you can go, we'll put this on the Jersey tag. But the worst part is when they pull you over, you know, if they just know they're going to, you know, they know you're going to ticket you, you know, and like 9 times out of 10, and they start off with that question, you know, any reason when you were speeding, any reason why you were speeding, and you feel like you just want to give a smart answer, just come out, yeah, there's something really scary back there, man. You better drive fast too, because they're right behind me. Here's what got me, though, because after the officer wrote me out the ticket, he says, you can pay me right here and now. You know, my first thought was, check, boing. No, man, he brought one of those little credit card things in the back seat. He like said, we accept any major credit. It was a true. I mean, I accepted my American Express, and I paid my ticket right then and there with American Express. I couldn't believe this. I thought, what a great idea. I hope every state in the union starts doing this, right? Right? All the state troopers start offering full-service banking on the road. What's this, an $80 ticket, officer? Well, I'm going to make this out for $200. I can use the cash right now, this part of the trip. Right? Thank you very much, Rich. We're opening up an account here at Ohio State Troopers. You'll come around to my truck, you can pick a blender or a coffee maker. A lot of it's about learning to avoid arguments. That's a big thing in any relationship, avoiding arguments. A lot of times arguments happen when we're driving. There's another area, driving. I don't know most times why I end up behind the wheel, but I do behind the wheel, you know. And it's like, and that's tough because if we get lost, we got problems right off the bat, you know. Like most guys, if I get lost, I will not stop and ask for directions. Right? For some reason, I'd rather get out of the car and put my ear to the ground than ask for directions. Ocean that way. We drive east. It's even worse when she's driving, because like most guys are the worst front seat drivers. Run the light, run the light, run the light! Ah, oh, you could have made it! I saw that truck, we would have missed that truck. Now we got to sit here for a minute. I had lost my license. Do you guys know it's like sometimes you're out there driving in traffic with the other drivers, man, you get competitive and that road warrior mentality kicks over? You know, whenever I start driving like this, my wife will start talking to me. She thinks she's calming me down, she's actually pouring gasoline on the fire. You gonna keep driving like this? You're driving like you want to kill yourself, and I'm in the car with you. I don't want to die, so you just want to let me... Don't look at me. Look at the road and nod your head if you understand what I'm saying. You let me out of the car right now, because you're driving like a maniac, 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 maniac.
You think I'm driving like a maniac?
I'll show you some maniac driving here. I'll take this car, drive right through that guardrail over there. And later, when they come to pull us out, they'll wonder what happened. I'm going to go back. Look on his face. He just got tired of listening to her crack. All right, I'll slow down. All right.